What's up, YouTube? In today's video, I'm going to show you how to elevate your Windows privileges by attacking unquoted Windows services. Let's get to it.
Login accepted.
All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to just open up a VM that's running Windows 7. However, this could be any version of Windows. So what we're going to do is attack unquoted services. So first off, what is a Windows service? A Windows service is basically nothing more than a program that runs in the background. Think of it as like a Unix daemon. These services generally start when Windows loads, but not always. Sometimes they can be manually started or started by other software. And these services typically run with system privileges. So where does the unquoted part come into? Well, let's take a look at our services. Whenever you install a Windows service, this gets a record inside the Windows registry. That's where Windows keeps various values pertinent to that service. So let's go ahead and just take a look at the services and the values that are stored. So you're going to go to HKEY local machine. You're going to go to system. You're going to go to current control set. And then once in there, you'll click the services section. This will list all the Windows services. So let's go ahead and click on one of these. And so here we're looking at VM tools for VMware. So the specific value that we're interested in is the image path value. And this value stores the location of the binary for the service. And as you can see here, here's the system path to the VM tools d.exe. I'm going to assume that D stands for daemon. So whenever Windows needs to start this service, it will come pull this image path value and execute this binary. Now notice that this value is surrounded in quotes. That means it is quoted and we cannot attack this binary or this service. What we need to do is try to find Windows services that do not have quotes surrounded by them. Now, if you click around, you're going to find many Windows-based services that are unquoted. For example, here's one for a driver. Now, we're not going to be able to attack this. Even though it's unquoted, we can't attack it because by default, the Windows services are going to be placed inside the Windows directory, the System32 directory, and these directories, a standard user is not going to have write access to them. And in order to exploit an unquoted service, we need to first find an unquoted service, and then secondly, be able to write to the directories in which the services is located. And I'll get into a little bit more detail on that in just a moment. So as you can see, we have many services here, and it could take a long time to sit here and try to go through these one by one. So I will show you a quick command line method of searching for any unquoted services. Now, to further illustrate this process, I went ahead and created a vulnerable service, installed it, and let's just take a look at it real quick. So you can see here's the record right here, vuln service. And here is the image path value, and you can notice that the binary is located in program files x86, vuln service bin, and then vuln service.exe. And as we can see, this value is not quoted. So that means that we can take advantage of this service being that it does not have any quotes. But there's still one further condition we have to check. In order to take advantage of it, we need to see if we have write permissions to the program files folder, which likely we do not. Then we'll need to check and see if we have write permissions to the vuln service folder, and then followed by the vuln service bin folder. If we have write permission to any of these folders, then we would be able to place a malicious exe and trick Windows into executing our malicious exe instead of vuln service.exe, whenever the service is started. And the service will start as system privileges. So that means we will be able to elevate our privileges from our user level to system level. Okay, so now this service is nothing fancy. Basically, all it does is whenever it starts and stops, it just simply writes to this text file in the C folder. And that's basically all it does. All right, so let's see, what do we want to do now? All right, let me show you how to search for unquoted services. All right, just for starters, we can see that I am a standard user level named Bob. Now so there is something called WMI and WMIC specifically for command line, which allows you to query various aspects of Windows and have information returned. And what we're going to do is we're going to use that to query the services and have it return specific information about those services. So to do that, you can just type WMIC service and then the parameters, or rather the values that you would like it to return. So we need to type git, and we want to get the name of the service, the path name of the service, and the start mode of the service. Now, start mode is what specifies how the service starts. So the service can be set to auto, which means it'll automatically run whenever Windows starts, or it could be set to manual, which means it will either be manually started by a user or a piece of software will start the service. All right, so let's go ahead and hit enter on this and see what we get. And as you can see, it returns a bunch of information, basically all the information that we were just looking at inside the registry. And you can see many of these are unquoted, and you can see several are quoted. Now, all of these that are unquoted, you can see these are Windows-based services, and we know that we're not going to have permissions to these folders, so they're irrelevant to us. So this is one method that you could use to try to find unquoted services. But as you can see, there's a lot in here. So let's take this one step further and filter out all of the irrelevant services and try to show only those services which are unquoted. So what we can do is we can take this output, pipe it into the findstr command, and then we can use the I option to specify that our search is going to be non-case sensitive, and then /V option to tell it to not to list any of these matches. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in Windows. Oops. Let's try that again. Fat fingers, /I, /V, / Windows. Now I'm telling it to do not return any results that contain /C:/ Windows. Okay, so that's going to get rid of all the Windows services, but we also want to get rid of all of these services which do contain quotes. So for example, this WMP network service, it contains quotes, so that means it's a quoted service. We wouldn't be able to exploit it, so we don't want to show that in our results. So we'll do /V, and then we'll just do 3 quotes, which says do not return any results that contain quotes. Okay, so just to rehash, we're going to get our results. We're going to pipe it in to the findstr command, filtering out any that contain C Windows, and then we'll filter out any that contain quotes. All right, so let's go ahead and hit enter on this and see what we come up with. Perfect. It worked 100% perfectly. So as you can see now, it only returned one service, and that service is the vuln service. And that was the vulnerable service that I created. And as you can see, it is not within the Windows directory, which is why it returned it. And it also does not contain any quotes. So, and we can also see that its start mode is set to auto. So anytime Windows starts up, the service will automatically run. Okay, so now let's dive in a little bit deeper into how we're going to exploit this service.